Dagger and Koin are without doubt the two reigning dependency injection frameworks in the Android kingdom. They both serve the same purpose and seem to work very similarly, but as it turns out, they are very different when you look under the hood. And what about Hilt? Hilt is a library that uses Dagger internally and just simplifies its usage. So everything I say in this video about Dagger is also applicable to Hilt. In this video, I don't want to tell you which one of those libraries to choose. Instead, I want to show you what are the differences between those two libraries beyond the things that you may see when you are using their API. And most importantly, what are the consequences of those differences for your app. So let's begin. So let's start from the basics. As the inversion of control principle says, class that is using the dependency should not create it. Instead, this dependency should be provided to the dependent. Or as the Hollywood principle says, don't call us, we will call you. Dependency injection, on the other hand, is a pattern that shows how the dependencies should be provided to fulfill the inversion of control principle. The most commonly used approach to implement that pattern is to provide a dependency through the constructor of the class. Why is it important to follow that principle? Because when we follow it, it allows us to easily substitute all dependencies with mocks in unit tests and easily test only one class at a time. And how does Dagger help us here? If we want Dagger to provide an instance of some class, all we need to do is to add inject annotation to the constructor. Adding this annotation causes that Dagger will generate a factory for this class at a build time. In this case, since the class name is CompositeAdapter, it will generate a class named CompositeAdapter underline factory. This class contains all the information that is needed to create this object. As you can see, it implements the get method that returns a new instance of a CompositeAdapter class. This is actually a method specified in the provider interface that this class implements. Other classes can use this interface to obtain an instance of a class. And as you can see here, to create CompositeAdapter, there is another class also needed, the ViewAdapters repository. And because of that, the generated CompositeAdapter factory contains a ViewAdapters repository provider field and uses the get function to obtain an instance of a class that it needs from this provider. And what if we use Hilt instead of Dagger? In this example, it wouldn't make any difference. Hilt is a library that uses Dagger internally, and the class I shown you was generated by Dagger. If you use Hilt, it does generate a couple extra classes for us that simplify usage of Dagger and reduce the number of boilerplate code that we need to write. But the core part stays the same. And what about Koin? Koin has a completely different approach to managing dependencies than Dagger and of course also than Hilt. To provide some dependency using Koin, we don't use any annotations since Koin does not generate any code at all. Instead, we have to provide modules with the factories that will be used to create instances of each class that will be needed in our project. The reference to those factories is added by Koin to instances registry class. This class contains the references to all the factories that we wrote. The key in this map is the full name of a class or a name that we provided if we used a name parameter. And the value is a factory that we wrote that will be used to create an instance of a class. To get a dependency, all we need to do is to call the get method, for example, in a factory, or by calling by-inject delegated property in activities or fragments. This by-inject delegated property calls get lazily under the hood. This get method will look for a factory registered for a class of a given type and inject it there. And here comes some controversy around Koin. Because Koin allows classes to get the dependencies that they need, it's said that it does not follow the dependency injection pattern. Why? Because according to dependency injection pattern, classes should never know where the dependencies come from and should never request for dependencies themselves. All the dependencies should rather be provided to the class. And because Koin does not meet those criteria, it's said that instead of following dependency injection pattern, it rather follows the service locator pattern. But if you think about this requirement, you may realize that it's not always possible to inject all the dependencies through the constructor in the Android world. If we use some activities, fragments, and services, we cannot pass some dependencies through the constructor, no matter if we use Dagger or Koin. So we are forced to request them differently, by using byInject in Koin or by adding inject annotation above a field in Dagger. In both those libraries, it's implemented differently under the hood. ByInject in Koin just calls get internally, as I showed you earlier, so follows a service locator pattern. And Dagger generates additional classes, responsible for injecting dependencies to this particular fragment, using setter injection. And setter injection is just another type of injection that follows a dependency injection pattern. But does it make any difference if Koin implements dependency injection pattern or not? Both those libraries serve the same purpose. They both allow us to separate the creation of an object from its use, and they both allow us to write unit tests. On top of that, service locator pattern is much more easy than dependency injection pattern. So the fact that Koin does not follow that pattern under the hood does not necessarily have to be a bad thing. So does it really matter for us that those libraries work differently under the hood? Well, there are some consequences of the fact that Dagger generates code and Koin doesn't. Because Dagger is a compile time dependency injection framework, if we forgot to define some dependency using this library, we will know about it instantly, because the project will just fail to build. For example, if we forgot to add inject annotation to the constructor in the composite adapter and try to inject it in a fragment, build will fail with an appropriate error which shows us exactly what went wrong. In Koin, the situation is different. Because it does not generate any code, if we forgot to add a factory for composite adapter class, app will build, but it will crash with runtime exception once we request an instance of this class. It might happen at app start, so we might notice it right away, but it can also happen later on some further screen or when the user performs some specific action. That means we may miss that kind of error if we are not careful. In Koin documentation, you may find an information that it allows to write tests that check if modules are properly set up. So maybe this is the solution. Unfortunately, those tests only check if the links between definitions are okay. So for example, they will fail when we have a factory for composite adapter defined and we forgot to add a factory for view adapters repository, but those tests won't tell you that something is wrong if we forgot to add a factory for a composite adapter that is injected in a fragment. But the fact that Koin does not generate any classes has some advantage. It does not affect our build time. Dagger uses annotation processor to scan our files and to generate all the classes that he needs to inject our dependencies. It may take some time and it can affect our build time. On the other hand, because Koin resolves dependencies at runtime, it has a slightly worse runtime performance. By how much? We can check it out in this repository, where Rafa Varquez measured and compared the performance of those two libraries on different devices. The test data was prepared in a way to simulate multiple levels on transitive dependencies, so it's not just a dummy app with four classes. As you can see, Dagger has almost no impact at startup performance. On the other hand, in Koin, we can see that it takes a significant time to set up. Injecting dependencies is also a bit faster in Dagger than in Koin. As I said at the beginning, my goal in this video was not to tell you which one of those libraries to use. I used both of them, Koin and Dagger, in two different quite big commercial projects, and to be honest, I think choosing between them is far less important than just using anything that will allow you to write code that is simple, clean, and most importantly, easy to unit test. And I think both those libraries, Koin, Dagger, and of course also Hilt that wraps around Dagger, fulfill those requirements. All those libraries have their strengths, and I hope knowing how they work under the hood will help you to decide for yourself which one to use, which one is the best for you and your app.